In this video, we are going to classify the forces in this universe. Before classifying the forces, first we have to know what a force is. In physics, a force is any interaction that will change the motion of an object. A force can cause an object with mass to change its velocity, that is, to accelerate. Force can also be described intuitively as a push or a pull. A force has both magnitude and direction, making it a vector quantity. Now let us know the history of forces. First, Sir Isaac Newton explained about forces in laws of motion that were not improved for nearly 300 years. By the early 20th century, Einstein developed a theory of relativity that correctly predicted the action of forces on objects with increasing momenta near the speed of light, and also provided insight into the forces produced by gravitation and inertia. With modern insight into quantum mechanics and technology that can accelerate particles close to the speed of light, particle physics has given a standard model to describe forces between particles smaller than atom. The standard model predicts that exchanged particles called gauge boson are the fundamental means by which forces are emitted and absorbed. Only four main interactions are known. That is, we can classify forces into four main categories. One is strong force or nuclear force. The second one is electromagnetic force. And the third one is weak force. And the last, not the least, is gravitational force. Let us look about these forces one by one. First, let's look at about the gravitational force. Everybody in our universe interacts or attracts with each other, which is called gravitation. And appearances of such interaction are due to the individual masses of the bodies where gravitational fields are confined. This reminds me of my school days. When I was 12 years old, I questioned my teacher why gravitational force is attractive but not repulsive. But there was no answer. But today, we are lot more theories yet to prove. Gravitational force is the weakest among all existing forces, and it is negligible for all lighter and smaller bodies, but becomes significant and considerable in all celestial bodies, that is, the big masses. Since the value of gravitational constant G is measured in torsion balance by Cavendish was very small, that is 6.67 × 10⁻¹⁷ Newton meter square per kg. We know that gravitational force is directly proportional to mass of two bodies and gravitational constant, and this gravitational constant is too small. So either mass of body should be larger to feel the gravitational force. Let us understand this with an example. Consider your mass is 100 kg and your friend mass is also 100 kg and you both stand 1 meter or 1000 millimeter apart from each other. Now, if you calculate the gravitational force, it is found to be 0.00000006743 Newton. See how much small is this? Now let's reduce the distance between you and your friend. Slowly, you can find that even after reducing the distance between you and your friend to 1 mm, gravitational force is still not reached 1 Newton. That's why this gravitational force is the weakest among all other forces. Now, let's see about weak forces. The concept of weak force came into existence firstly in Yukawa's meson theory, when explanation of beta decay was propounded. In the atomic nucleus, electron emission, that is beta particle decay, take place spontaneously during the conversion of neutron into a proton by ejecting a pi meson. Yes, it's true. In atomic nucleus, proton is produced from neutron. When this conversion happens, pi meson is produced. Later, this pi meson is converted into an electron and an antineutrino. Thus, a single neutron is converted into a proton plus electron plus antineutrino. This equation is also known as beta decay equation. You can see this equation in the shown image. Here, the weak force arises because of the interaction of electron and antineutrino, and this interaction is weaker than nuclear force and electromagnetic force and stronger than gravitational force. I repeat, the interaction between electron and antineutrino is known as weak force. Next, let us see about electromagnetic force, the most familiar force among us. If we touch any object, our hand or with any part of our body, we can feel it. This feeling is nothing but electromagnetic interaction between you and the object you touched. Electromagnetic force appears on all charged particles and provides atomic and molecular binding force. Thus, electromagnetic interactions are charge-dependent, attractive, as well as repulsive. The electrical and magnetic force appear in the form of electromagnetic force, and the combined effect of these forces produces photon or quanta. If both the electric and magnetic force act on a body, then it is called Lorentz force, given by F equal to charge of the particle multiplied to electrical field strength plus charge of particle multiplied to velocity of charged particle multiplied to magnetic field intensity. The electromagnetic force is one of the strongest forces. If you want to experience this force, you can try it just by lifting any weight or object against gravity. Since electromagnetic force between your hand surface and the object surface is stronger than gravitational force, you should be able to lift the weight or object. Thus, it proves that electromagnetic interactions are stronger than gravitational interaction. At last, the strongest force of all known forces. It is also known as nuclear force. Among all the forces found in nature, nuclear force is the strongest force, which basically exists within atomic nucleus between proton-proton, neutron-proton, and neutron-neutron within the range up to 10 power minus 15 meter. That is, within a small range that you can't even imagine. Experimental evidence of the nuclear physics observed that nuclear forces are primarily attractive, non-electrical, non-gravitational, non-central force, extremely strong, but spin-dependent. And the magnitude of the force is same for proton-proton interaction, proton-neutron interaction, and neutron-neutron interaction. Explanation of the nuclear forces was completely based on Yukawa's meson theory. Some scientists also assume that the nuclear force originates from the mutual interaction of two quarks. If you don't know what quark is, just watch the previous video given in the description. Now, let us compare the relative magnitude between these forces or interactions. First, let us compare nuclear force and electromagnetic interaction. Here, nuclear force is 1000 times greater than electromagnetic interaction, or nuclear force is 1000 times equal than electromagnetic interaction. Then, next, let us compare electromagnetic interaction and weak interaction. Electromagnetic interaction is 10^11 times greater or equal than weak interaction. And then let us compare electromagnetic interaction and gravitational force. The electromagnetic interaction is equal to the 10^36 times gravitational interaction. So here we can find that nuclear interactions are stronger than all other interactions. The carrier particle responsible for this interaction is pi meson. Now, let us see the carrier particle responsible for this interaction. The carrier particle responsible for nuclear interaction is pi meson. Next, let us see the carrier particle responsible for the interaction of electromagnetic interaction. Photon. Photon is the carrier particle that is responsible for electromagnetic interaction. Next, intermediate portion for weak interaction. And at last, graviton for gravitational forces. Thus, we have found the particle, that is the carrier particle, the responsible for these interactions. Thus, if we find the relationship between these forces, then that equation will lead us to the theory of everything, the theory that we as a human waiting for.